Today, I will discuss about the origin of English language. Basically, what we know that English language, as we know today, is the amalgamation of multiple languages taken from various countries. So, it is to say that English has nothing of own, and by the way, through a few slides that how the English language has been originated during the periods of time. From first of all, here we will say that in the slide, it is said that a brief history of English, and it is to say, first of all to you, that why this language is so difficult to master. Actually, as English language has nothing of its own words, so it takes the words from the various and multiple countries, and that's why we could not master this language at a time, because it has so many sources. And first, now I will say about that how this language originated throughout the time. This is the prehistoric pre-Roman period, and before that, I will. I want to show you the Indo-European languages. That what are the Indo-European languages? See this map here. That Indo-European languages. First of all, if we look into this picture or map, we could understand that the basic part of this United Kingdom, that is where England is situated, and beside that, Ireland, Denmark, and Germany, North Sweden, all these are from the influence of a very Germanic language. And basically, the English language which we read today is the amalgamation of Anglo-Frisian languages. So we can understand, or we can say that maximum of these languages has been the influence of these Germanic languages or Indo European continent. Here, besides that, here we can see that very languages, basically the Celtic, as well as the Celtic is in the form of a very green shade, or and the Romans is the light green here. That Romans language has been come from here. You can say that there's this Portugal, Spain, and Italy. San Marino, and besides that, I want to say you that the very part of the Russia is the Slavic language. They used to talk in the Slavic language, and after that, now. Yes, this is the very overview of this English language throughout this period, and when each and every country has invented this Britannia. And I will say you that previously the Britain, which was named from the name of Britannia, and which we know as Britain now it is, and this Britannia or Britain has been invaded by many countries. Just like in the 55 BC, we can see here that Gales, Britons and Gales has invaded or had invaded. And before the 55 BC, and from 55 BC to 407 AD was the emperor of the Romans. And thirdly, we can see here that the Anglo-Saxons were the were has ruled here from 407 AD to 787 AD. And later on, we can see that the Vikings and invasions were started from 787 to 166, and 166, which we know basically as the Norman conquest, when we have the glimpse of the French influence. And so we can see that the English language, which has been formed throughout the years, if we look one thing, that when each and every country are invaded, they make their influence each and every sectors of the civilization, not only from the cultural background, but also from the linguo-social aspects of and the life of the Britain or Britannia. So here, one thing we can see that if we go through these periodic times, we can see that the Celts, the pre-Roman invasion, and how they influenced the very peoples of the Britons or the Britannia. See here that the island we know as England was invaded by two groups of people. First, the Celts, known as Britons, and the Gaels, who settled on the island now known as Ireland. So if we want to see the places, then we should move to the picture once again, or map once again. See here that North Ireland, this is the Ireland, Republic of Ireland, and here all these two, and here in this Wales, and as well as in this here in Britain, first of all, Celts and Gaels invaded. And secondly, the Celts were the pagans, and their religion was as animism, a Latin word for a spirit. So we know that paganism, that what is paganism, and how believe in the multi gods, and they also believe in the spirit. And the Roman invasion, paganism has been abolished, and the Christianity has been introduced. But still now, the date, we can see here the influence of paganism. Now, the Druids were their clans had disputes, they intervened, they settled them. And see here that when they have settled here, and how they influence, not from the cultural perspective, but also from the perspective of the language. So now, the very section of this period, that English language has become the amalgamation of the two. First of all, it was the nation of the Britons, and from the invasion of the Celts and the Gaels, they have introduced their own language and culture. So it is now an amalgamation, or the mixed language, which you could see here. And after the Roman invasion, after the Celtic invasion, we could see that the Roman occupation of the England, how, and now Julius Caesar begins invasion, occupation in 1555 BC. And this occupation completed by Claudius in 1st century AD, and Romans leaves in 407 AD because of the Visigoths attack Rome. It was after, see here that when the Roman Emperor becomes so weak, Visigoths attack Rome. So, and at that moment in England, the Saint Augustine, or St. Augustine, lands in Kent and converts the king Ethelbert, the king of Kent, the old Saxon settlement, and they have turned them to Christianity. So now the pagan religion has transformed into Christianity. Okay, and we know what is Christianity, and becomes the first archbishop of the Canterbury. So the king Ethelbert was the first archbishop of Canterbury, and see here how the Romans has made an influence throughout these years in this England, not from the very source of cultural instinct, but also in the languages. And within these Romans, the Germanic Roman language had influenced the. So the most important results of the Roman occupations, they established camps that eventually become towns, maintained relative peace. Actually, when before it was, actually Roman was so very powerful, and their kings and their subjects were also powerful, so they never made any of the invasions successful. So they tries to keep this England in the relative peace, and Latin heavily influenced the English language. So with the influence of Roman, here we can see that the Latin heavily influenced the English language. Not only here, English, I will not say about that the whole English language, because at that moment English was not formed yet. So the very beginning of this, or the very sprouting of this language, has been influenced by this Latin language. And